Well, it's a live match again. I know you guys absolutely love it. And I'm actually fishing a four-day festival. It's actually called the Durleigh Festival. It's in Bridgewater in Somerset. So basically, you get 3 days on Durleigh Festival, which is a big, big open water, big reservoir, lots of roach, some bream. Well, there's lots of bream in there, but they're really, really finicky at the moment. I'm actually fishing my last day. And the last day is actually on a different day for me because of my rotation. We're at a lake called Dunsweir, which is just down the road. For me personally, I think I've got the wrong rotation for the festival. Day one, on the far side of Durleigh, there was quite a lot of bream caught. Mark Bartlett actually won the day with 37 kilo. He's had a 10 kilo carp in with that. And then he had 10 bream. Someone else had 30 kilo of bream as well. And after that, the last 2 days, it's been absolutely, the bream have just shut up shop. It's amazing. I don't know why. You would think personally that the bream fishing would get better. But anyway, at the moment, I've won my section on Tuesday, which was the first day because it was a bank holiday week, with 13 kilo. I had one bream late, about 2.5 pounds. I've caught some silverfish on the pole, even though it's really windy. The second day was a complete disaster. I've drawn peg 9. There was a big algae plume during the day and during the night, and it was so thick where I drew. I was at the end of the lake with the wind blowing down, and it was a shallow end. And I think with the great big breakers that were coming down, big waves, I think the algae's mixed in with the water and pushed the fish up the lake. I caught absolutely nothing. I caught a kilo. Admittedly, I did fish the feeder for 4.5 hours because I was out of it. And I thought the only chance I got was to catch a bream or one of the elusive carp that live in here, because there's not many carp and they are big, I know. And I thought, well, if I do get a bite off of a carp, anyway, it didn't happen. Yesterday I had a real lovely day. I drew the section that caught the weights on Tuesday. It was a bit of a gamble. I put loads of bait out on the feeder line, but chatting to a few people on the phone, it wasn't happening. And basically I just fished the pole all day back to back, 10 meters. I couldn't catch on a whip. And I've ended up with 16 kilo 600 of all roach. An amazing day's fishing. I won me section. I think I might be fourth on the lake, which is a result. But today I'm out of it weight wise because Dunweir, the top weight of the week, is 11 kilo. And so realistically, I've got like 30 kilo at the moment and 60 kilos winning. And I think you're 50 kilo second. And it's just not going to happen. But anyway, Zolt's with me. We're going to get the Dunweir in a minute. I've just sorted some hooks out. I've gone through a few hooks yesterday. I've used these all week. They've been absolutely amazing, to be honest. I've not tied anything up. So I'm just sorting a few bits and pieces out, and I'll get back to you when I'm at the peg at this lake called Dunsweir. Just about to do some ground bait now. Well, I've never fished this lake before. This is the fourth day, obviously, that's had three other matches on it. And it's actually got, I think, a little bit worse, which I thought it would be, because it is a natural lake, as you say, stunning lake, to be honest. And filming with Zolt today, I just said to him, as soon as he walked onto this lake, it's like a lake in Hungary, where he lives or where he used to live. And it is just like that. Lots of options. That's the biggest thing about this peg. I'm out on a point. It looks lovely. But let's run you through a little bit of ground bait. I'm not going to set up a lot. A lot of these fish are being caught on worms and maggots, not that much ground bait. But I'm going to mix a little bit of green F1 and a little bit of natural pro fatchers. I'm not going to do a lot. I'm literally going to just put a couple of handfuls of green in. I'm not going to measure it out because I really don't fancy putting loads of ground bait in. All accounts, it's really, really silty, this lake. And when you get a decent fish in your peg, whether that's an eel or tench, there's a few skimmers being caught. It fizzes like hell. Literally, everybody says it's like a plume of bubbles that come up.
And yesterday, speaking to a couple of guys this morning at the draw, they actually fouled hooked a few fish, fishing off the bottom. It was just like the bottom's that soft. They're in your peg, they're off the bottom. That's something I'm gonna have to go really careful of today. And I think putting too much ground bait in, especially when it's warm like it is, it might not be the case, but I'm gonna mix a bit up anyway, because you never know. I would have a ground bait line. And I'm gonna put, it's probably 70% F1 green and 30% Pro Fatchers. So mix that around. I have got a drill, but to be honest, for how much I'm mixing up, the only thing with a drill, you can actually mix it, and it just makes it so fluffy. So that's it, I'm gonna leave that for like 20 minutes. Look, lovely mix, just that sort of green color, a few little specks of natural ground bait in it. But like I said, I'm not sure how much I'm gonna put into this, but like we do wherever we go, you know, you have to have a bit of ground bait with you, because on the day, and especially today, I think it's gonna be tough. It's 6 kilo won this match yesterday, which is about 13 pound. And I don't think that was that many fish. So I think it's gonna be a patience day. Hopefully for you guys to pick up some tips, the fishing will be okay. I really don't know, but I'm gonna get now and sort some rigs out whilst that's setting, and I'll just drill it again and get it dead right. So before I start. We got about 20 minutes to go. So while I'm waiting, I've got all my bait set up. I'll just run you through the rigs and talk you through the peg that I've actually drawn. Now I'm right out on a point. The worrying thing is how shallow it is. I've probably got just over 3.5 foot of water. That's the deepest water I can find. No matter where I plumb up, this is virtually exactly the same. I've got a load of reeds to my left. It's not that much shallower actually fishing up against the reeds, but let's talk about rigs, because there's a little bit going on, because it is a natural lake. It is going to be about catching everything, you know, little fish. Hopefully there's quite a lot of tension here. Some people have been catching like between sort of 6 and 8 tench. They're obviously going to be a massive bonus today. Some of them are quite big, some of them are quite small. There's been some eels caught. Some of the eels have been big. There's been a few big eels lost. So in my mind, you know, I can't fish too light, especially on some of the rigs. But anyway, let's talk about the rigs. Now, the rigs I've made out for long, I've decided to fish 14.5 on my main lines, and now I'm gonna base that round chop worm fishing. So it's gonna be about putting neat worms in and looking to catch tench. As soon as I found out about this place, there was tench, few eels, I thought, and there was a lot of little fish as well. I don't, you know, obviously, trying to catch, it's all right if they're that big, but there's a lot of tiny fish and I don't want to get them really. If I want to catch them, I want to catch them short. Anyway, the first rig I've set up, this is the 14.5 meter line. I've set up a 9 jawer. It's probably going to be a bit heavy for the small fish, but obviously bearing in mind there's an odd tension, odd big eel, I can't fish too light. 013 main line, I've set up a 4B16 F1 maggot, and I've done that for one reason. One, the wind's a bit in my face, which is going to be a bit of a pain. And two, it's quite a nice float. If the little fish are there and they are a bit of a nuisance, I can get it down through them, or hopefully. What I found out this morning was the little fish do fade away as the match goes on. So I think we're going to have to fish big pieces of worms. I mean, I might start fishing, not get bitted out. I've just got to wait and see. Anyway, 013, a simple bulk of number 8s, one number 9 dropper, and I've got a 6-inch hook length with 012, and I'm just using the pre-tied Magstore N10s. This is what I've used at Durleigh. Honestly, they're absolutely unreal. I use them every day on the pole, and they're just so easy. So it's 012 to a 14, because if I do hook an eel, I've got a good chance of getting out on 012. I can go down to 010 and a 16, but I'm gonna try and stick to 012 and a 14, because I'll be fishing with worms. So 4B16 F1 maggot, fishing about normal, just like half a float length over depth, because I am fishing for quality sort of tension stuff. The next rig I've set up is basically exactly the same elastic, exactly the same main line, but it's just a 4B14 version, just a little bit lighter. And I got the bulk slightly further away from the hook length. So I got the bulk, some number 9 and 2 number 10 droppers. So later in the match, if I think there's a few skimmers about, I'm trying to catch these little fish, hopefully it'll make a difference. But we'll wait and see. Exactly the same hook length. It's an 010 to a 16. So it's the same stuff off the mag store. So it's a little bit lighter, but I will be trying to stick with the 4B16 rig and 012. A couple of rigs I've set up short. I've set two rigs up short. One is a 4B10 Chianti, number 6 original slip. So this is a top kit plus one. The first rig I've set up is to actually fish to hand, because if there's a lot of these snotty little rud, little skimmers, little roach, I want to be sort of fishing to hand on my top 5 line. So I've got the rig basically the same length as the top kit. So I've plumbed up the fish on the bottom, but obviously I can bring this off the bottom and start fishing shallow. If I start throwing maggots in, it's basically just to try and put fish in the net if it's really, really tough, because it has had 3 days matches on here and I think that's going to affect it. One of the other rigs I've set up for the same line basically is a short line top 5, which is a 4B12 Chianti. You can see the difference there. It's actually got like 18 inches of line between the float and the elastic connector. 6 slips, so it's just short lining on a top 5, where that other rig is fishing to hand on that long line or on that top 5 line. So at the moment, I just got it strung out like that in the sort of first 2 foot. And again, 010 to a 16 N10, because we are allowed to fish barbed hooks. The only other rig I've set up is for fishing down by those reeds. You can probably tell by the camera, or you will see it from the camera, they're all cut off. But there's been quite a few tench and eels hooked down by the cover. The only thing is, I haven't got deep water. I'm not sure what's going to happen. It might be a good thing today, it might be a bad thing. And all I've set up down there is 017 Jura. I've actually took a bit of elastic off to make it tight. 021 mainline. I've got a 4B14 inline diamond on there. And I've just got everything bulked down. Literally a bulk, a 6-inch hook length. And on there I've got 015 to a an N50 hook, which is one of the barbed, really strong hooks that we do. Because it is barbed hooks, and with eels and stuff like that, obviously, hopefully it won't come off. And that's it, simple bulk, because it is getting down through the small fish if they're there. I'm only going on the information that I've got over the last 3 days. And that's it, really. It's all going to be based around chop worm fishing, I think. It, especially at the start of the match, when these little fish are feeding. I have set a feeder up. I've set an 11-foot SL. With braid on, it's a sort of the rod I've been using it, Tamar. I'm going to put a little bit of gear out there at the start. I'm not sure if I'm going to go on it, because there hasn't been that much caught on the feeder here, but it's there just in case. And I'm going to put a few feeder falls out at the start, as much chopped worm as possible. And I just think neat worms on here, when you're fishing for eels, you know, get a few bonus eels and a few snot, you know, a few small fish. I think it'd be quite, as long as we can get some bites, I think it'd be quite interesting. I just hope that the last 3 matches haven't killed it. But like I said, talking about the festival itself, it's a bit of a gutter really, because the first day has sort of wiped most people out. There was a lot of bream caught on the far side of Durleigh, and The two front runners, which is Mark Bartlett and Adam Palmer, they were in that section on the first day when there was a lot of bream caught. And Mark actually caught a 10 kilo or nearly 11 kilo carp, which is a massive bonus, and fair play to him to get it out. And then after that, the bream really have just not really, there's been a couple caught, but like I did yesterday, I'm phoning a few people up in my section and they're not catching on a feeder. They might have had one skimmer, one bream, and that's what's happened. It's been like the last couple of days at Durleigh, the pole and whip anglers have been doing the best, because the bream have just shut up shop. And I suppose my rotation, where I've actually drawn like I did on Wednesday, with a real windy day. They had an algae plume, and I think the wind blew it all down my end, and because of the big waves, it actually put the algae in the water, and the fish just, I don't know, I think they just felt a bit sick. They went up the lake, and there's nothing you can do about it. So I've been a bit unfortunate in that respect, but I've enjoyed it. The fishing, apart from Wednesday, the fishing's been amazing. You know, I've had 13 kilo of mostly roach on Tuesday. Wednesday was a disaster. Yesterday I've had nearly 17 kilos of roach, which was an awesome day's fishing. 10 meters on the pole. Unfortunately, I couldn't catch on a whip, just they wouldn't come in short. And then hopefully today, I'm not going to get in the top. Yeah, I'll be lucky to get in the top 20, really. But I'm just going to try and win my section today, really. And there's a prize. If you actually win your section throughout the week on weight, there's another prize as well from, I think Matrix are sponsoring the festival, so thanks to them. And Mark, who's over there, I'm 2 kilos in front of him for the actual overweight of the week section. So there's a lot on it today. It's a beautiful day. It's an absolutely beautiful lake, which I've never fished. Fingers crossed, the fishing's all right, and you can pick up some tips. But let's hope so. Let's go. That's it, isn't it? All in! Right, we're just starting now. Now, my plan of action is basically put a little sloppy ball in of worms in ground bait short. That's where I'm going to start. And out long, like I said, is I'm going to put some worms in. I'm not going to miss about half a pot in like that. We're going to go through some worms today, that's for certain. Well, hopefully, if we catch some fish, anyway. So 14.5 meters. I'm not going to put any casters with it because I'm just worried about these tiny fish. I want to try and avoid them. So I've got myself lined up with a couple of trees on the far bank. I've actually got two lines at 14.5 meters. I'm going to dose one with worms. I'm just going to put a little tiny, little soggy ball in of worms in ground bait like I put in short. I'm not gonna put too much in because that line over to me right, I'm sort of thinking, I don't know, just wanna leave it and just see what happens. I wanna concentrate. I don't want loads of lines going, even though I have got a few. So this is the line to me right, way out of the way of the other line. And I can just keep my eye on that because it is going to fizz. When I was actually plumbing up and I was chatting to Zoll, I said, you watch this. And I was putting the plummet in, and anywhere you drop the plummet, it fizzes. So I think the fish will certainly give their self away. And everybody I've spoke to have said the same. So that's down the edge. I'm going to put just over half a big pot of just chopped worm in it. This is just a shame with these tiny fish. When you get a lot of these little, a lot of lakes in this area on the levels can be absolutely solid with little tiny snot fish, and they can be an absolute pain, but that's the way it is. I might have to fish for them. So that's all me line. I'm just going to chuck the feeder out. I've not really got any confidence with the feeders. There's not a lot being caught. I think peg one, which is an M peg, had some fish on the second day, but not enough. So I'm literally going to put, let's get me ground bait over. Ground bait, unfortunately, I think at the moment, it's not going to play a massive part for me unless I go in. I'm just going to cast a few big feeder falls out. Got a big X mesh on there. Just get some worms out there. It's just worm central, basically. Just had a feeling chatting to some of the locals on Tuesday, which was the first day. And when they said, oh yeah, there's like tension in that. And I thought the bottom's soft. It's probably like an old peat work. Just concentrate a minute. The poor old 11 foot SL chucking that big feeder out. just shows how good them rods are, really. Only fishing about 30 metres. And just hopefully get a... I don't know what's going to happen, really. I'm not sure what... I don't think this peg's been particularly great over the last 3 days. But when you're fishing for an odd bonus fish here and there and a few little fish, you never know. I'm just going to get out a good strike. The only thing you have got to watch coming to a lake on the last day like I am is them little fish shut up shop completely. And you might be able to sort of put more ground bait in. But that's the thing is, with that, I can add it. I'd rather like add it as I go because I don't really know what's going to happen. You see then, I just struck the feeder out and some little, there's lots of what they call motherless minnows in these lakes. And they can be an absolute nuisance. They are tiny little like bleak like fish, and they are honestly, they drive you insane. I just hope that they're not gonna, well, let's hope they, if they do feed at the start, they won't feed at the end. So I'm gonna get me short line 4x12 Chianti. Make sure I got the right rig, yeah. And just go in there with a single maggot on. You never know. There's a guy called Bruce who I spoke to this morning, and he said, I don't know what peg he was on. He wasn't on this peg. And he said he started short, actually on a whip, and caught some... He actually caught some little tension, there's some little tension here, like pound fish. There you go. Bite straight away. Oh, they're all right, little roach like that, see? Don't mind them. Just get me landing it out of the way. See if I can take Zolt's head off. Zolt, he's there. Did I hit you?
No.
Good. It's obviously, I'm sat out on my platform because I think it's a bit nicer. I didn't want to sit up on the bank. This is one of the pegs that's actually got like rocks in front of it. So I'm not going to loose feed anything at the moment. The only thing I am going to do, off to an angle, which I said to Zolt, I'm just going to throw a few maggots. It's a sort of a throwaway line. And I'll just see what happens on that little sort of pasty bit of worm that I put in. I mean, they're all right. Ounce and a half fish. Don't mind catching them. You could catch 10 pound of them. And like 6 kilo, which is probably 13 pound. Won the lake yesterday. So 6 slip, 4x12 shanty. Just like lowering it in and getting it down there. I got some hemp with me. A little fish come off. That wind's just gonna be a bit awkward. It's just like side on. Absolute pain. Oh, that was a better fish. It was definitely a nice little dumpy fish that come off. Obviously, I'm putting a little head of, like my favorite sort of fishing is like putting little bits of head of worms on. So I've got my little throwaway line, maggot line. That wind is really awkward. They're all right then. you know what I mean? They were saying they were that like tiny, tiny fish. But I can put up with that. It'd be even better if the wind buggered off. I'll just throw a little bit of hemp over the top. That's why I've got that. The only problem is me rig to hand might be a little bit too small. I set a 4x10 up, so I thought if them rudd and that comes shallow and you need a number of them, I'd have to fish a little rig. But at the moment, it's just basically get me head down, catch whatever I can. It's going to be really awkward to see any bubbles. That's the only thing when it's windy, to see any bubbles coming up. All right, 2-ouncer. So yeah, I'll catch up it shortly and keep informed of what's happening. But at the moment, quite nice. Nice to get a few bites early, that's the thing. Right, we're gonna be going for about 45 minutes. And to be honest, a short line has actually been all right. So I'm just topping up my long lines because I obviously dosed a bit of worm in at the start. I'm just chopping a few more up. Even though we've only been going for 45 minutes. I've had some rudd, some little dumpy roach. Actually quite nice fishing, to be honest, I can't lie. I mean, they're not the biggest fish in the world, but there's been no fizzing. I'm looking at all my other, like, keep me on the other lines. I started on a maggot. I'm just fishing at the moment, probably a piece of worm, about an inch, so yeah, about half an inch long. So still top five. There's a few bubbles just started coming from that short line. But we just started catching a few little dumpy little pommies and stuff. But if you can see my short line, that result can pick it up. There's just a few bubbles coming up. But like I said, the bottom's so soft, it might not be big fish. It might be the roach that are just pecking around on the bottom. I'm not throwing nothing over the top. I did actually start there. So I started on maggot, I've got little heads of worm at the moment. Then roach, they're actually all right. Bearing in mind the top weight has been 11 kilo. It's 6 kilo won the lake yesterday. So at the moment, I'm just trying to like keep my eye out my other lines. Because I think them big fish will give themselves away. It's gone flat com at the moment. So if anything, if it does fizz, I can see it. I'm throwing maggots down here. Just like a throwaway line. I mean, there are eels and that in here. You know, you don't know. You make your own luck on these lakes sometimes. You know, it is one of them. There's a few little motherless minnows. These little motherless minnows, you can probably see them pecking on the top here. They're an absolute pain because they actually attack the bottom of your float. And they give you false bites. Hopefully they'll back off as the day goes on. I mean, they're all right, see? If you're trying to catch, you know, I don't mind catching them. They're like 2 ounce just over. You know, you're gonna need a lot of them to do a weight, admittedly, but it ain't like Durleigh where you're fishing for 30, 40 pound of them. And Zolt's told me that there ain't a lot being caught or what he's seen. Is that right, Zolt? Or he's looking around. I think we can see 5 anglers out of the, I think it's 9 in this section, so, you know, so just throwing a few maggots down here as a throwaway, keeping my eye out, and just keep putting fish in the net at the moment. It is a 6-hour match, so we got ages. Little pommy, nice fishing, it's like a little canal sort of sized fish, really. Obviously, I would like to get some quality, but I think if you're going to catch quality here, it'd be a bonus skimmer, an eel or a tench. There is some bream in here, but they don't seem to be feeding. There was a couple caught. I just don't know about this shallow water, whether it's going to affect it today. There's obviously a lot of little fish in here, and I might have messed up a bit because I have set my store around fishing 14 and a half meters, and I'm sort of thinking to myself now, should I have brought that back to 13? It's too late now. So I'm just trying to catch as many of these little fish as I can, just go through numbers, and you never know, you know, the next bite can be a tench, can be a skimmer, it's just one of them. But at the moment I don't really know what to do to get a bonus, if there is anything I can do. But it's just nice, just heads of worms feeding it. I've fed that line twice since we started, with a golf ball size every time, just smaller than a golf ball size. Not loose feeding, because I just don't want to drag all those tiny, tiny fish in me peg. I'm trying to keep, that's why I'm chucking maggots to me left. If I do actually need to sort of fish for them later, I'm just trying to make, you know, trying to make the most of that. It's nice fish, you know, really, even though they are small, it's quite nice. I'm just a bit disappointed that I really thought the bonus fish might feed early, and I've not seen a single bubble, but I might have to go out and have a look. Them little fish have definitely settled on that. A little bit of worm, bit of ground bait. So that's six, I mean, they're all right then, see? If he was on a canal catching them, you'd be like, well happy. I did start chucking a little bit of hemp over the top, but I felt the bit of oil in that was coming off of it was keeping those motherless minnows around me float. So I stopped that. So I've just topped up. Same to me, right, a little bit of ball of ground bait and then some neat worms out in front, but not a sign of any bubbles or anything yet. I did actually pick up my top kit to hand, but it wasn't any good. I think the rig is probably, that is the trouble, fishing lake that you've never fished before. It's probably a bit too light, but it really, that rig was there just in case things went absolutely pants, and I had to fish for anything like these little things, really. But I'll keep going, and we'll catch up in a bit. But yeah, literally 4x12 Chianti, head of worm, not loose feeding, just topping in or cupping in those putty balls of worms and ground bait, and just taking everything that that swims at the moment. Nice fish, you know. So, well, I've just gone out on my 14 and a half metre line. I just said the Zolt, I'd need to go and have a look and see what's happening. I'm not sure what this is. Feels like an eel. So I actually went out there, caught a roach, probably 4 ounces. This feels like a decent eel. I'll take anything on this lake, to be honest. I've never had a bite. I never actually had a bite on there, and I left it. I went to have a look at my right-hand long line, where I put a little bit of ground bait in. It was the same fish as what I'm catching short. So I thought I'll have a little look over my neat line. And I said the Zolt, it might be a decent fish there. That's actually an eel. Which Zolt, by all accounts, has never caught an eel. So where has he been in the world? I do not know. Not a very big eel, but I'll take it. I'm not going to pick him up because they're horrible. Probably about 10 or 12 ounces. Absolutely absolutely manked to death the hook length. I'm not going to say on film what it looks like, but it's going to take me a little while to clean it off. I know that. So that was on a whole little dendra. Let's go back at her again, because that's what I'm trying to do, you know, trying to catch sort of everything. So whole medium dendra, just cut his tail off like that. That's why I'm fishing that nine Dura, really. But there weren't no bubbles. Now, whether this bottom's a bit harder out there, I don't know. Because when I chucked the bomb out to just have a look on the feeder, it just felt, I said the result, it felt really firm. And a little indication then. Oh, go on. Another indication though, that was. Might have been a little fish, to be fair. Little fish. Just got to keep ploughing on and definitely going to attack this today with worms. I'm not going to mess around too much because I think a lot of the bait is being ate by them little fish. There you go. Oh yeah, hello. It's a better fish. It's that little lift bite then. I think it's a skimmer. It's not a massive fish, but certainly one that could... Oh, hello, that'll do. Sort of nice little skimmer. Probably 10 ounces, I reckon that. What we want, get a few of them mixed in. I just wanted to say, I want to leave it about, I left it about an hour. That's what I used to do on the Kettenham Canal when I used to fish that. I always felt the hour was the time to go out and have a look. The only thing I've got to go careful of, like I said, is don't neglect that inside line. Not sure about that line I got off to the right. I mean, I did put the same mix as what I put short. I went out there and I won't just sort of forget about it, because late in the match that might actually be really important to keep the fish. That's why I'm just feeding these maggots down there. You know, might be a complete waste of time. Let's just drop back in on that. Oh, that looked like another little bite then. The thing is, I've not had a single bubble out there either, which this bottom round here, it might be quite firm, which they might not give themselves away like they have in other areas. And there we go. That's a little indication then. Oh yeah, hello. That's what we want. That's a good fish, that. That feels like a good skimmer, that. So I put 3/4 of a pot of neat worms in. I left it about 40 minutes, put another handful in. Might be a tench, that. Hey, old Tinker, look. Nice tench. Probably a pound and a half. Look at him. Hey, do like a nice tench. You ever caught a tench before, Zolt? Yeah. Well, he has caught a tench, so that's a bonus. All right, Zolt, don't rub it in. I don't know if you actually heard that. He said, I've actually won a tench, won a match with a tench. Anyway, that's enough of that, Zolt. So, it's quite a big hook bait. I mean, fishing for tench, which I have done, not there aren't many venues really with tench in, but I do know tench are really fickle sometimes. They'd either have real tiny baits, or you've got to put a big bait on. But that is one thing I've learned already, is I think the bottom round here is different to where they've been fishing. But that might be a good thing, because yesterday I spoke to a couple of people and they said they were actually foul looking fish, like a foot to 2 foot off the bottom. And they said it was absolutely fizzing like crazy. So I'm fishing half a foot length over. Just a little bit more than normal. Look at that, that was another liner now, I think. It might have been the wind actually. As I said, I am fishing for tench. Never a fish then, it's only a small fish. Not a bad roach though. Oh, it's like a pommy that. Maybe 4 out, 5 ounces. So the 14 and 10, fantastic hooks, honestly. If you do any sort of natural water fishing at all, canals, rivers, lakes like I'm fishing, N10s, N20s, honestly, pre-tied on the Aki Power, take some beating. I just give up tying them now. They're just pointless. They're so good. That's actually nice fishing, actually. I mean, that, there's one thing I've just noticed. I've caught that eel, caught that tench. Oh, it's old Percy. And straight away, I've caught two sort of little fish. And that's what I said to Zolt when I went out there. I went in, first of all, with nothing. I went on to my other line to me right. I caught two tiny little fish over me, little bit of ground baiting worms. Went back in there and caught that eel. And that might be the case. If a big fish comes in your peg, the little fish just go. But what I'm going to do when I come back next time, I'm going to feed my short line again, and I'm going to also feed my edge line up to the reeds. I'm not sure if that edge line is going to be any good, but with tench, eels, you know, anywhere where there's a bit of cover, it's always an option. Well, I've just gone down the edge again. I think that's a great big eel, actually. Float, I haven't really gone under. If that's an eel, he's a big one. He's actually gone in the reed. He's actually gone in the reed and come out, but it's going to be a bit of a bonus. I'm not worried what it is, really. The 17 Jura. Oh, I don't believe it. I don't believe it. That was a massive eel, wasn't it? That was a proper big eel. That is going to be costly in this section, I think. Joke. That actually went in the reeds. I've got it out of the reeds. What a nightmare. Because the float never even went under. It's just sort of sat there for a... I seen it nudge a little bit and I thought I'd leave it. Because if it is an eel, I'll just leave it. It's definitely a big eel. I thought it was a tench straight away because it went straight into the reeds. But that was a great big eel. I'm not sure how big it was, but it was a big one. It was a proper bonus for the day. Gutted. It's actually come off. I don't think it was fouled up because I actually waited for it. Because it was sort of like you see your float just sort of inching along. What an absolute gutter that is. He knew where he was going, straight into the reeds. I thought he'd actually bit me line through, actually, but it hadn't. It just come off, which is like really unusual for eels as well. But at the moment, let me just talk you through. I've had two little tench. I can catch those little rudding ropes short. Long, I had a skimmer, a tench, two eels, and a few little small roach. And down the edge, I've had one tench, only a little one, probably a pound and a half. And I've had a skimmer probably down there. I can't fish light down there. I mean, it's just an absolute waste of time because that, obviously even that then, that was an eel. I honestly thought it was a big tench because it went into the reeds. I got it out, got it up to the surface. It was a great big boil and I thought that'd do, a great big tench, but it was a big eel that. It actually swam. They don't get, you know, the ones that actually swim forwards are normally the great big ones, and that's what that was doing. But I bet it was £2 at least. So that, you know what I mean, that was a costly fish. But there ain't a lot I can do about it. So I've just gone back in. I'm just topping up my short line, still throwing them maggots slightly to me left. But I'm sort of concentrating on that line down the edge and my long line out in front. But my last long line, when I went out, I caught an eel, probably like 12 ounces, maybe a pound, and a few little roach. Just felt I was going to get like another tench or something, but it didn't happen. And every time the float went under after that, it was a little roach. But they weren't too bad. They're not tiny roach. They're all right. So I might have to like maybe start fishing little pieces of worm out there for the roach that are there later on. But at the moment, I'm trying to catch quality, just trying to give myself a chance of winning me section and winning the lake. But it is tough going at the moment. I don't want to loose feed any fin out there. I think it's just pointless. You know, if I'm going 14 and a half meters, I'm looking to catch sort of quality fish rather than trying to catch 100 little fish. I can, if I want to catch little fish, I can catch them short. I'm gutted about that though, absolutely gutted. It was definitely an eel. But I've just literally fed me long line again out in front. It might just be the case of it at the moment, just like trying to catch, you just don't know on this sort of venue, you know what I mean? It's a natural sort of venue. You make your own luck, do you know what I mean? Anytime that float can go under, it can be a bream, could be a tench, could be an eel, could be anything at all. You just do not know. It's just a gutter. There doesn't seem to be a lot of sort of skimmers, like big roach or anything like that at the moment. It just seems to be like either tiny fish and then the odd bonus fish, which is an eel, tench. It's just a shame really that I've, you know, it'd be nice if ever, it just looks like you're just going to get a skimmer every chuck. I might have to just feed that again. I think if I go in there, if the float goes under, it'd be an eel or a tench. And you have got to be patient for these, you know, in this sort of venue. If you get them big eels in your peg, they sometimes are really crafty. You have got to wait for them. That's why I'm sort of feeding maggots down here, because you never know. You could get some eels there. But at the moment, I've got two tench, two skimmers. I don't know how many little fish I've probably got, like 50 little fish I would have thought. And probably got 6 to 7 pound, I reckon, something like that, I would say. Might have 3 kilo. I just spoke to Mark, who's on peg one over there. He's admitting to 2 kilo. He's got a tench, two eels and a few little fish. But he said he's really struggling for bites. I think the 3 days of matches being on here, certainly in this area of the lake anyway, the shallow end, I think as we go around the corner over there, you can't even see anybody. The lake, it's quite a big lake this. They might be catching more down in the deeper water. But it is a bit of a struggle. I can catch them little fish, I just want to give myself a chance of just trying to catch some bonuses. You just don't know what's going on, so it's really difficult to make a decision on what to do for the best, really. But we'll keep you updated. Obviously, a bit of a gutter that, especially when he's filming it as well. Absolutely gutted. I'd like to have seen that, because it was a big old eel, that. I'm going to just put some more kit down in there. It is like one of them places you can't, even though the fishing is hard, there's one thing you can't do is just not feed. So I'm gonna put a good handful of neat worms in. I might even put a few dead maggots in this time. Get that down in there. And just have a quick go. Quick go back out long. So I fed that before I went down the edge. And just want to go and have another look on that. Even though last time I went out there, it was pretty poor. Although I did catch a pound eel, so. Quick look out there again. Just topping up that short line every sort of 15, 20 minutes, just to one of those soggy little balls of ground bait with a few worms in it. Wind's got up now. Wind's really bad actually. That side wind's not very nice at the moment. There we go. The skimmer, that's good. So doing that, leaving that line, topping it up. Whole dendra on there, not the biggest dendra. And that's what this venue's about. It's literally about making your own luck. Just feels like you're going to get one of these every chuck. My skimmer, probably 10, 12 ounces. So that's three of those size skimmers I've had. But I have got my 4x14 set up. For that line with a 16 on instead of a 14, just in case I want to go out and start fishing little bits of worm. But I don't get the feeling for that. It just feels like to catch a quality fish you're gonna have to fish big baits, especially out there. But we keep plodding along. Like I said, just keep the, I'm just throwing maggots, sorry, throwing maggots slightly to my left. Keep topping that top five line up with a little soggy ball of worms and ground bait. And out long is literally neat worms. I could introduce some casters in that. I'm just a bit reluctant with these little fish. There's a tiny little indication then actually. These little indications sometimes, you know, be them eels moving around. Just trying to hold it dead still in that wind. You know, what's going through my mind is, you know, do I drop back on that short line, nick a few little fish? But obviously I've just hooked that great big eel down there. I've hooked a skimmer out long and that's what I'm trying to, you know, you never know. Any second now it can go under, it can be a tench. That's what I'm hoping and praying for. Some nice bonus fish. Definitely seems if you're going to get one though, it's pretty quick. Like even down that edge, I dropped it in within probably 2 or 3 minutes. I had a slight little indication. Same out there, it's literally like really quick. There's a bite. That was a little fish, that. Tangle on. I'm struck like a man possessed then for some reason. Change that up, got a bit of a knot in the hook length there. definitely no bubbles. What everybody was talking about. Now, whether that's just because where I've sat, it definitely ain't like that. That float sitting there, absolutely lovely. Just looks like it's going to go under. There we go. That's the only thing. There is a few of those little dumpy roach out there. They're actually all right. That's a little pommy. Probably like 4 ounces. I might just try my 4x14 out there. Put a 16 on. Just see if I can catch. I don't think there's loads out there, but if I fish a 16 with a smaller piece of worm, I might be able to catch them whilst I'm waiting for a better one. Oh, that felt a bit better. Not sure, but it did feel, definitely felt a bit better. I just don't think kinder potting either, a little cab pot on there, it's, you know, I think if there was a lot more quality fish about, bigger roach, not getting hammered by little rudd and stuff, I think you could sort of cad pot worms in. Just don't feel it's that sort of venue. It's a better one again. A few little dumpy fish out there, because I lost one of them as well, last chuck. Don't mind catching them. A nice roach. A red roach hybrid. Just half a dendra. Just drop that straight down. A few maggots. But well, next chart, I need to feed that. Need to feed that top five line just to keep it ticking over, just in case. It's exactly the same. I caught that skimmer, like 10 ounces. I've gone back in and I get bites off a little fish. When there's a quality fish there, it just seems to be absolutely dead. Or there's nothing. Like that. But I'm putting the ounces in. And if it's fishing really hard, with what I've already caught, I mean, it is a natural water. It's not the easiest of natural waters. Especially when it's had 3 days of match fishing on it already. I thought it was going to be actually harder than this. But we'll get back to you. We'll keep going on this. Like I said, the next move for me, I've got to go and have a look down that edge again, because I don't want to miss a chance of probably getting another tench or even like another big eel. I'm just a bit gutted that that eel come off, because today that's going to be a real bonus fish on here. I think in this area anyway, I can only see like 3 anglers. Well, 4 anglers. And I don't think there's a lot being caught in this area. So what I'll do, I'll keep going on this, get back to you, and fingers crossed, we can keep putting fish in the net by rotating each line. Just hooked another eel down the edge. To be honest, anything counts at the moment, because it's rock hard. At least I got him out. It's not one of the biggest samples in here, but he's not happy. And the hook's come out and is in the net. That's unbelievable. That's really unusual for an eel. Normally, you've got to get the hook out. And I left that as well. I had a liner. It's definitely one. I could just sense there was something in there. He had a big one. I'm not even going to try and hold it up, because I'll be back in the lake. So that was down the edge. I had like 2 or 3 indications down there. Which is definitely from them eels. So I'm just going to go back in. I actually had, when we come off that long line, on my short line at the moment, I'm just going to go back in, because I've had a couple of little blows come up. I'm just going to go and put another bit of chop worm in down that edge. Because to be honest, it ain't like you can go back in and catch another one. It really feels like you've got to get a bonus fish, feed it, get away from it. They're just not having it. So I'm going to put a few dead maggots in down that edge as well. Just willing it to go under with a great big tench. Just still haunting me, that eel that I lost, to be honest. Really disappointed with that. That was a, when you're talking like 2, 2.5 pound eel. That's going to be a really good fish today. I'm just going to go in short. Not that one, wrong rig. Let's put a head of a worm on. Just sense it's getting worse and worse. When you start catching eels, there you go, straight in on that short line. Definitely still a few little fish there, I think. Definitely had some blows come up though. There's a little blow now just inside me float. And whether that's a little tench or an eel, look, there's definitely some up moving around on this short line. A little blow's right on my float at the moment, literally right under it. That's definitely a quality fish, that, of some sort. Whatever it is, I need it. Could definitely do with it. Oh, look at that, right under my float. Same old scenario, really. Fizzing, you can't get a bite. Oh, there we go. That'll do. Now, that's quality. Oh, hello. Now that, I don't know what the hell that is, but it's a damn good fish. And it's a fish that I need out. But I did say dissolve. There's definitely one in my peg. And I think this is a big tinker. Oh, hello. That will do very nicely indeed if I can get that out. Yes. That's what we want. Look at him. Absolute stunning tench. I knew he was aero, and I didn't think it was, well, obviously I didn't know it was a tench or an eel, but that's probably getting on for £3. Lovely tench. Let's get him back. Well, I've got another eel now. That's on that 4x14 rig. I actually put a few dead maggots out there as well with my last worms. And I've just got two eels, a skimmer. So I don't mind catching these. I mean, if it's fishing hard, at the end of the day, it's all weight. They're not massive eels, but that's probably 10 ounces. I wouldn't be moaning at that if that was a 10-ounce skimmer. So I'll take that, do you know what I mean? So it's just basically building the weight up, and yeah, it's not the nicest of fish to catch. It's nice to see eels, because I used to actually fish for these babies years ago on the River Huntsville. You're actually fishing for eels, and we used to actually catch one a chuck. It was ridiculous. You just couldn't believe how many eels were in your peg. And we all know nowadays, with everything that goes on in the world, eels have a rough old time, and you know, I mean, they're important. And you know, I bet there are some absolute monstrosity eels in this lake. So that's all right. I mean, I'm just like, I've caught that, you know, a bit of bonus. I caught that tench. I said the zolt. There's definitely something in me peg, and luckily I caught it. I'm still chucking them maggots in, and it's going all right, really, I think. You know, I don't mind catching eels. I've had two eels for probably a pound and a half. Not being funny, if that was a pound and a half tench, you'd be well happy with that. I can catch little fish short. I'm fishing my 4x14 out there at the moment with a 16 with a smaller piece of worm. And it was really weird. When I actually picked it up earlier, I went out, dropped my rig in, I caught an 8-ounce, 10-ounce skimmer, first chuck, on a smaller piece of worm. Not sure it was making any difference at all, but for me, I was like, well, if I can bring like a 4-ounce, you know, 2-ounce roach, 3-ounce roach, a little skimmer, a little pommy back, and then hook an eel, I mean, that's what this day is going to be about. And then hopefully, you know, I've got 3 bonus tench. I've got probably 5, I think I've got 5 skimmers between 8 ounces and 10 ounces. What have I got now? I think I've got 4 eels. Lost that great big eel, which is still in my mind, which I'm not overly happy with, but there you go. You always remember the ones that got away rather than the ones that you got. But I've just put some dead maggots in, and even down the edge I put like a small handful of dead maggots in with me neat worms, thinking that them eels, they do love maggots. And if they've seen worms over the last 3 days, you know, they're not silly eels. You know, sometimes they can be really difficult to catch. They're in your peg and you can't catch. And maybe later on, if I need to, I'll put like double red maggot on or 3 red maggots. And but at the moment, it's actually all right. It's not great. It's not, you know, there's no rhythm as in quality silvers. Whether anybody else is catching some bream somewhere else on the lake, I don't know. That feeder for me is, I just think it's a no-no. I've seen Mark over on peg one, he's chucked the feeder out, and that is meant to be a well-known feeder peg. I don't think he's caught anything, because he went out there very long and he's back on the pole. So yeah, hopefully, I think I've probably got double figures now. which is all right, you know, like considering, there we go. Oh, I thought it was going to be another eel then, but they're all right. These little fish I'm catching, not quick, but they're slightly bigger. If you look at this one, it's probably a roach or a little pommy. You know, you can soon put a weight together of them. So I just look in that edge. Just want to make my mind up whether to go into that edge. Because I did feed it probably 20 minutes ago. And in that 20 minutes, I've had two eels out there. A couple of those little pommies. Still feeding them maggots down there. I mean, I might even get some eels down there, maybe. But I'm trying to just concentrate on sort of these three lines at the moment. Because you have got to be concentrating on each line. You can't sort of, you know, you've got to be patient, wait for a bite. It certainly ain't in. The only line you can catch steady, really, is that top five line. And a lot of them fish are like an ounce and a half, which is all right. Yeah, look at that. I think that's another little pommy. Just, you know, just keep putting the ounces in the net. That's a perch, don't mind them. Wasps absolutely everywhere. It's that time of year now when the wasps come out. They seem to like eel slime. Either that or a following Zolta bait, I'm not sure really. Probably his Old Spice deodorant he's got on. Actually, enjoyable fishing. I know it's completely different to what we do normally, you know, following me through a commercial, but this is the sort of lakes I was actually brought up on. Natural lakes, you know, hard fishing, but really enjoyable. I love it. Another nice little dumpy fish. So that's on my 4x14 F1 maggot. 010 to a 16 N10. Look at that. You know, I mean, they're a nice little dumpy skimmer. Lovely fishing that. Zolt loves this sort of fishing, don't you, Zolt? He thinks he's back in Hungary. I know one thing, I am hungry. I've had the three biggest breakfasts I've had over the last 3 days that I've had for absolutely years. But it's really nice because it is a, you know, the match don't finish till 6 o'clock tonight because of the walks and stuff. So you get plenty of time to set up. But look at that out there, 14 and a half meters, lovely fishing. Another little fish. You know, if you start adding all the ounces up with what you've got already, you soon sort of, they're all right. They're just not like, I wish they were obviously a bit bigger, but they're actually all right. When people said to me over the last couple of days, oh, there's tiny, tiny little fish. I'm thinking of like fish that are just really pointless. But they're actually all right. I can sort of deal with them. Even though I do like catching a few bonus tench and stuff like that. Just trying to time myself. I don't want to leave that edge line much longer. I think this lake's gone most days. The second day is fish that's best, and I had a feeling it would be, being a natural lake. The second day fish well. There was 11 kilo, a couple of nine. I think there was like 3 or 4 9 kilos. And then yesterday it fished its worst, I think, up to now. And then today, obviously we don't know. Oh, that was a little dumpy. I think that was a little dumpy pommy. It just feels like you want to loose feed casters, catch through the water, but I just don't think it's that sort of place. I think if you've done that, you probably catch them tiny fish, and I just don't think it's right out there. I just wanted to keep it neat, you know, neat worms, especially with them tension eels. And you can catch everything over it, which is what we've done today, really. But I am debating whether to just top this up again and just have a quick look down that edge. Because like I said, it ain't quick, this. You've got to be patient. There ain't millions of fish there. I'm not sure if that was a little liner then. Oh, look at that. That felt a bit bigger, that. Now, whether that was actually fouled up or not, I don't know. But I did say a little liner. It's light, I don't know, even them eels. I think you get a liner off them eels as well. I had a liner earlier and I pricked some up and I dropped it back in, caught a 10 ounce eel straight away. And the bubble then. Seen a couple of bubbles come up. Not where I'm fishing, but just past. Just open, it's a great big tench. Another little dumpy fish. Lovely fishing that. Look at that little skimmer again. A little pommy. Really nice fishing. Might not be doing any good, mine, but. I just think it is that sort of venue where you've just got to make your own luck, like I did with that tench short. I've seen a few bubbles come up, went in there and caught it, and I think that's probably what this venue's all about, really. But they have been caught, you know, three matches on here over the last 3 days. There's been quite a lot of, if you look to my right out there, there's a big plume of bubbles come up, but I'm not sure, that might be just gases. Ooh, a little indication then. Little fish. I've just got my rollers set up absolutely perfect behind me. So you can ship back the full 40 and a half. Really important when you're catching these little fish long. Everything's got to flow. I've sat out on my platform to get down nice and low. Makes a huge difference. I think I swallowed a fly. You just know a match like this on this lake, every single fish is going to be so important. It don't matter whether it's an ounce or, you know, I've lost that big eel, which I'm absolutely gutted about, but that could actually cost me winning the lake today. I was absolutely gutted. And it was weird that I've actually hooked. One of the 10 ounce eels I had a while back, I actually hooked, got it in the landing net, and I pulled the hook, and it was quite a deep hook, and the hook comes straight out. And that's really unusual for eels. But I'm just gonna, I think now, it's just see what happens in the next 5 minutes or so, and I'm just gonna top that up. Even though the fishing is hard, there's one thing for certain, you have to top it up. It's not the sort of venue where you're just going to put a little bit of bait in and keep catching. Different venues, amazingly, you can put like what I fed already. Yeah, just going to top that up now. And just have a quick look down the edge. So I'm going to put some neat worms in there again, some dead maggots. More chopping required. It's a little handful of worms, some dead maggots. Just keep my eye out, just keep my eye on that short line, just for a fizz. Nothing's come back. Oh, look at that, that was a tench salt. Tench this top to my right then. Let's get down that edge. Hopefully. There's some up there waiting for that big dendra. Looks like you should be catching every single chuck down there, but it ain't like that. And whilst I'm waiting for that, I'm just going to get a little bit of ground bait, get a few more worms in there. Few dead maggots for that inside line, that top kit plus two, because when I come off of this and go back out on my long line, just going to drop another little ball in, so I'm doing that whilst I'm fishing, little ball like that, see plenty of worms in it, so that's all ready to go. I'd love to fish a bit lighter down there, but can't risk it. And to be fair, them tench, they haven't fought really hard. That one I had short, it was only on a 6 slip, and to be fair, it's sort of shot off. Different venues are very different with tench. I've been to venues where they're the worst fish ever. You just can't stop the fish. But here, luckily, they seem to be pretty reasonable. There's about an hour to go now, and I'm on my desperate line. I've actually caught a few little pummels on that top 5 line, where I've been putting that little bit of ground bait in and worms. It actually started blowing, just little bubbles, and I could catch little tiny pommies. But believe me, they've been hard. Now at the moment, on this maggot line where I've actually been throwing, basically from the start, I've now got my 4B10 Chianti rig, which is to fish into hand, and I'm catching little rudd, and they're small, but they're actually all right. You know what I mean? Look at that. I know it's like tiny, it's quite small, but I'm catching them white one a chuck. And it is sort of desperation. Unfortunately, I got seen off by an eel. Well, I got it nearly back to the net, and it actually bit me up length off, which was a bit annoying, because it was probably about a pound. But I thought I'd just have a little look on this, and have a look. You know, I mean, they're all right, you know what I mean? Sort of getting near the end of the match, an hour to go. And I think, well, I'll just go in and have a look. But that short line is been all right, but they've got harder and harder to catch. Little pommies, it's blowing, there's an odd bubble come out. It's like them pommies have actually just sort of settled on the ground bait. A lot of them are small, but I thought I'd just go on this, try and just put some extra ounces in the net as quick as I can. I mean, they're all right, that's like 1.5 ounces, 2 ounces. Just throwing maggots in. A little strung up rig. I mean, to hand, if I had to break down on that, it'd just be too slow. That's why I set this little rig up. Just basically fishing a top kit to hand. You know, it's not hard work. I'm just trying to just keep, and you know, hoping that what I'm doing it's sort of going to win me the lake and win me the section, even though it's not going to make any difference overall. It is just trying to win your section, win a few beer tokens, and yeah. And like I said at the start, there is a prize for the highest section winner. I mean, he's all right, little roach. You soon put a little, you know, soon put a weight together. Especially when you're fishing for like 10, 12 pound. This might make a big difference, I don't know. That's it, that's an hour to go. Obviously I've topped up that long line again before I come off it, because that was the only bite I had out there, was that eel. It's definitely gone. It's definitely sort of slowed right up now, I think, for everybody. I'm basically fishing a strung out rig, full depth. And I'm catching them little rudd on the drop, like that. Bit like bleak fishing. Probably could have done with like a little 2 or 3 meter whip, to be perfectly honest with you. But I think because I've fed it from the start, they're all settled there. There's quite a lot of them there. Could always come up shallow. You wouldn't believe they were there either. That's the amazing thing. It's not like they've been swirling at the maggots that I've been throwing in. Few of them little motherless minnows there, which are a bit of a pain. That's about the only things that have actually been showing. As soon as you get a suck maggot, them motherless minnows are on it. An absolute pain in the neck. Believe me, on the matches, this has got me out of trouble no end. Don't matter what festival you're fishing, you know, maybe not on like a sort of high weight commercial. But white acres and things like that, I've had little, you know, this little rig set up for just doing this, and I've ended up catching skimmers, roach, you know, odd bonus carp. It's just like I said, sometimes, a lot of the time, you don't even need it. But day like today on this venue, I mean, it's a bit of a gamble doing it, admittedly, but the way it's fishing at the moment, I would think it's fishing hard for everybody. And if I can just put a few pounds together with what I've got, hopefully it'll be there or thereabouts. Even though there might be an odd fish, I think the big fish, by the sounds of it, the big fish get caught quite early on this venue. Like bleak fishing, like fishing for England again, this. I might come up. It's pretty quick, to be fair. Might even come up shallow. Just have a go shallow. Might be some slightly bigger rudd up in the water, but it seems to be quite nice. Like that, to be honest. I'm quite happy having that on the drop. And like I said, they're not tiny tinies. There's a few little babies, but they're all right. If they were like the really, really snotty ones, I'd probably chuck this up the bank, but that's got to the bottom now. You never know, you could hook an eel or, you know, a little tench or something like that. Might go off anyway, you never know. That might not last for long. Let me just try shallow. Just come right up in the water just to try it. You never know, there might be some slightly bigger rudd right up. Thought that would have gone straight away. That's unbelievable. That's what amazes me about rudd sometimes. You think, well, you're going to catch them right up in the water and you can't. Let's just go back down again. Oh, look at that, amazing. Oh, you bugger. Slightly bigger than that one. Oh, that's two in two chucks I've lost. Oh, no. Don't want that. That is the only problem with fishing a strung out rig. If you lose one, you can get an almighty tangle. Hopefully this is going to come out. Yes. Little pommy. You can do this sort of fishing on your local canal, local little, you know, little lake. This is where I sort of done all my stuff with my parents years and years ago. We used to actually call it dapping. I used to actually tie my line on the end of my rod and just use a matchstick and just literally flick it like a whip. I used to catch absolute tons of roach, perch, when they used to come up in the water for your loose feed. Looking at the other lines to see if any bubbles. The long line, has been no bubbles at all. I think that bottom out there must be quite hard. Even when I've had some eels and stuff in me peg, I've had absolutely no bubbles at all. Just starting to fade away now a little bit. Look at what I've had in the last sort of 10 minutes, I suppose. I would have thought. What do you reckon, Zolt, weight-wise, doing on them? A pound or so? So, you know, I mean, I'd take a pound skimmer now, wouldn't you? That's the way I look at this sort of fishing some days. Who are you? That's sort of on the bottom, eh? We're not off the bottom. It's either on the drop or nothing. That is like dead depth there, eh? Just nothing on the bottom, really. Just don't know if I go down that edge. Love that to go under now with a nice big tench. That was a bite on the bottom then. There's a few tiny, tiny fish up in the water. Tiny little things. Ooh, better one on the deck. Right on the bottom. I'm scraping the barrel, I must admit, but I think this time of day, I think it was always gonna go harder and harder. That top five line, still odd little bubble coming out, coming up. Come here. But yeah, 45 minutes to go now, and decision time, whether to sort of stay on this, have a go for an oddie or a bigger fish on that long line. I did feed it before I had a go on this. I've got my edge line, but my edge line, last time I went in there, I'd literally just caught two roach. Sort of think I'm in front around this area of the lake. I just don't know about the rest of it. What I'll do, I'll get back to you with like 10 minutes to go, 5 minutes to go, right, sort of run you through the last knock into the match, and hopefully, fingers crossed, I've done enough to sort of hang on for maybe the section win, but who knows. I think that some people might have had some other bonus tench. I just hope it's fished sort of hard for everybody, and I'm in the shout of like winning the lake. There's some lake prizes and stuff to have, so. 5 minutes to go now, and just a little recap. I've actually caught two eels and a little pommy in the last 10 minutes. So I caught, what I actually had done, I caught an eel, I caught a little pommy, where I'm fishing now at 14 and a half out in front. Literally dropped it in, caught a little pommy, then I've dropped it in again, I've caught an eel, there was a bite then. That might be another eel with a bit of luck. Another little indication, look at that. Don't want to strike too soon. Oh no, what a prat. Oh, not sure if that was a little fish or an eel. But anyway, I caught an eel, probably 12 ounces. And then I thought, right, there's no point going back out there. That's one thing I've learned today, is really, if you catch an eel, on my long line especially, and down the edge, if you caught an eel, there's a little roach, if you caught an eel or a decent fish, you had to feed it and get away from it. Nice little roach, though. I'll take anything at this time of day. So what I'd done, I caught that eel and I thought, right, I'll go down the edge, and I dropped in, and I literally, the worm hit the bottom, and I caught another eel, probably getting on for a pound. So, you know, that's what this match has been about. I think I fished like a real nice match. And obviously I caught the eel down the edge, literally before we started filming again. And I've just gone back out on here because I fed it before I went down the edge again. And I thought, well, there's no point me now going back down the edge. I thought I might be able to sneak maybe an eel or whatever I can at 14 and a half meters. So there's literally, I think it's, 3 minutes to go. But it just felt like I needed to leave this probably longer than what I have. But it's the end of the match. I've really enjoyed it, to be honest. It's been quite technical fishing, really. I mean, that short line I've started off with, that was nice. I mean, the fish weren't big. I'm a bit disappointed, really, that I've not hooked. I just felt like I fished a nice match and I've not been rewarded with like a bonus, like a bream, or, you know, even a couple more tench. Like, even when I was catching those rudd to my left on my top kit to hand, I just felt like with a few eels about, I was going to catch an eel or maybe even a tench fishing on the bottom with maggots, and all I've caught is little rudd. But I've probably caught 3 pound doing that. So that's like, you know, you add that up. I haven't got a clue what I've caught. I haven't got a clue. I mean, Zolt, I've asked Zolt, I reckon I got like 13, 14 pound. I don't know, it just depends what the eels weigh. Sometimes they're hollow and sometimes they do weigh. I just really don't know. I haven't got a clue. I can see Peg One, Mark, he's had some eels. He's had some big eels. Obviously, I don't know what they're going to weigh. The two guys to my right, I've not seen them. I've not really been watching. They're behind me, really. But yeah, it's just literally last knockings now, and I'm just hoping. Oh, another little roach, look. You just know, you sort of know inside now what I wanted to do was feed that, leave it. But it's all too late for that. But it's been a really enjoyable day. I know it's not everybody's cups of tea nowadays with all the commercials that we fish, but honestly, this is where I brought up this, you know, using different lines. I've not put ground bait in long. Whether that was a mistake or not, I don't think it was. I think I wanted to go out there really and try and catch the bonus fish. And I have had a few skimmers. I've obviously had that one tench out there. There's a little fish there now. And that down the edge, really, I've looked just a bit disappointed that I've lost those two eels. The big one down the edge and the one I got seen off, or it bit me off. Yeah, I solid little fish now, but it's too late. I'm just going to keep following along. That's actually come off. But yeah, really enjoyable. Probably fished a little bit. It's always with them eels, I've had to fish a bit, even out in front, I've had to fish a little bit heavier than what I probably wanted to. I don't think it's made any difference. Definitely that 4x14 rig with 010, I think it's caught me a few sort of pommies and a couple of little sort of 6-8 ounce skimmers. But all in all, I've really enjoyed it. You know, using three lines. It's just a pity that I haven't had like a bonus bream or something. And what I'll do is literally, you know, I think we've probably got, well, it's all over now. So what I'll do, I'll show you what I caught and have a little chat afterwards. That's it, innit? I call it, that's it. Yeah? All right. Right, well, the match is now finished. Obviously, I've packed some other stuff away. The scales have been round, and I've weighed in 10 kilo 950, which I think is about 23 pounds. So I've had a mega, even Zolt was pretty impressed with that. He didn't think I had that. I thought I had about 15 pounds, to be honest, but it just shows you all the little rud, you know, the eels. I had three little tench, I had that one decent tench, two little tench. But I think I fished, I don't, you know, it's one of those days you think, actually, I fished a real nice match, you know, rotating the light. It took me a little while to sort of get into it. And I found probably halfway through that actually feeding it, going on it, the only line I could actually feed and go on it was that top five line. That was them little tiny balls of ground bait and worms. I honestly think I had my sort of experiment line over to the right and I fed that the same. And when I dropped in on it, I could catch the same fish. And I thought, there's no way that I'm actually going to ship in and out at 14.5 meters to catch the same fish there and what I can catch at top five. And that's why that neat worm line, I didn't put any ground bait in. I just felt maybe it dragged all those little fish in your peg. I didn't mind catching them at top five because it's quick, it's efficient. You know, you're putting your weight together. I caught a few little pommies. Obviously caught that 1 2-pound, 2.25-pound tench there. You know, it's been really, really good, to be honest. It ain't, you know, I know it's not everybody's cup of tea, but this is where I was brought up. This is why we filmed it today, to give you the tips. You know, there is eels in here, like there is in some venues, and they've been important today. Mark, who's been over there, has had some absolutely cracking eels, 2-pounders. I mean, I've lost one big one, and I've been bit off by one. And really, that's the only couple of fish that I've lost today. But neat worms has been mega. I just had a feeling even before I got here, when I found out about what was in here, eels, odd skimmer, you know, odd tench, I just felt neat worms could be the score. And I think, to be honest, for the bonus fish, that it's been dead right. Rigs, nice and simple. I have fished a little bit heavier than what I probably would for those little fish, because I've had a fish like a 9 Jorah, where normally I'd probably fish a 6 Slip. But that was for a reason. Again, eels, you know, if you're not careful, they'll rag you, especially these reeds and that. They could end up taking you around the reeds and you're finished. But there you go. I hope you've enjoyed it. I felt like I fished a real nice, tidy match. I've won the lake. I've won a few quid. You know, the festival for me was over really sort of after day one, unfortunately, with the weights that they caught on the far bank. There's nothing you can do about that. I'm pretty sure, I don't know the results, but I'm pretty sure Mark Bartlett has won the festival. He was quite a way ahead. He's had 37 kilos on the first day. He's fished brilliant. I think this is the third or fourth year he's actually won this festival in, you know, in concession. So mega, you know, he's a good friend of mine. He's a fantastic angler, not just a carp angler. He's brilliant at all sorts of different fishing. So fair play to him. I think Adam Palmer will come second, and I'm not sure about third and fourth. But well done to everybody. And thanks for watching, and see you on the bank sometime.